it's awesome, you know. And then they just turned the lights on because when you first walk in, I thought that that was the regular lighting. I thought it seemed a little bit darker than I was expecting. And then they said, no, no, it's not even close yet. So they just popped them on, and it's just beautiful. They've done a great job, and it's just got a great feel to it. First class all the way. And I didn't get a chance to coach in here at the high school level. They haven't built it yet. But I watched a few games here. This is my first time on the field, so it's pretty awesome.
How important is it, you think, to maybe get the kids out here and let them get the awe factor out of the way before they come out here and get down to business?
It's important. It really is, you know, from the perspective of just walking in here, but then also it's the reality of catching punts, catching kicks, catching passes. You know, the lighting's different. Just being able to know what it's going to feel like, what it's going to look like, and, you know, kind of finding the ball, tracking it when you're trying to, you know, special teams, you know. So those things are really, they really matter, and just a familiarity. So it's just kind of like playing the next game instead of something new.
For you personally, is this the first time you will coach a game here since Ben Davis?
Yeah, it is. And so I just feel like that it's, Big Ten championship games played here. You know? So that's our season starts here, and the regular season ends here. And so that's the goal. That's what we set, and that's our objective. And so just be able to get in this venue. You know, it's a beautiful place, and this is kind of my second home, you know, born in Newcastle and that area, but spent 9 years in Indianapolis and Ben Davis, and so this is just a special place to me, and it's great to be home.
Can you believe game day is quickly approaching?
No, we just were talking about it on the way over. You feel like you're on your, you know, you get on the buses, and it has that, Friday feel when you're heading to the location you're going to be playing at. So it's hard to imagine that it's already back again, you know, 2019. I guess we got games tomorrow, you know, we're just talking about that, but that's the start of college season. So it's here, so it's definitely a fun time. I can't wait.
Get the quarterback question out of the way. How are they looking, and when are you comfortable making?
Yeah, they're doing a great job, and so we're going to announce it early next week. So it's coming close.
You feel like as it gets so much closer, less than 10 days now, you've checked all the boxes, or do you feel like, man, there's still a million things we need to get done?
You know, we feel good. You know, this is actually, this is my third season as the head coach, so you kind of get more comfortable with that. I know you're still nervous. You always feel like, you know, in the yesterday staff meeting, what have we had not covered? What situation haven't we got enough reps at? And then where do you feel? And I was going back and watching more film last night, just trying to get some more gauge for that, just to feel like that. I don't think you always feel like you got everything. You haven't checked off for sure, but sometimes you're like, well, you want to do that again. And so we're talking about those kind of things for even tomorrow's practice and what we want to get accomplished next Tuesday and Wednesday. So, but yeah, I don't think you ever feel, you know, to the point where you say, hey, we got everything, you know, you got them all worked on, but you always want to keep working.
Exposing these guys to kind of like NFL locker rooms and an NFL atmosphere, how much do you think that kind of energizes them, and how can that be good for future?
It pumps them up. I mean, they love it, you know, and this is where they want to be. You know, these guys want to play in the NFL, and that's an awesome goal to have, and many of our guys will have that opportunity, and they got teammates that are playing there right now, and you guys trying to make teams right now, you know, so I just think any time you get a chance to be around the very setting that you want to aspire to be at is a great motivator for sure, and it's kind of a nice change of pace too from fall camp. You know, we've been in the grind of the same scenery every single day and same practice areas and all that, so it's nice to get over here, and we're going to actually, when practice is over, we're going to go over to Topgolf and have some food and some fun and relax a little bit, get a little, see if these guys can hit a golf ball.
How's your game?
It's not very good.
Did you have to pry him out of the new locker room to get him back?
I tell you what, when it's been that way, you know, they're like, in the past we had to, you know, it was easy to get him out, you know, but now they're like, Coach, you must stay, you know, so, but now they love it. It's awesome. It's a beautiful place, and it's great to have for a program.
Not starting with a conference game, but no slouch, obviously. This is an in-state matchup. Oh, yeah. Bragging rights on the line. Just to be able to start the season with a game of this magnitude really set the tone for this team in this building.
It does. The location, the opponent, in-state, you know, it's a big deal. We are, our staff fully understands the magnitude of the game, and it's your first game of the season. It sets the tone for everything. So our guys will be ready. There's no question about it.
Now the camp is winding down. I mean, how do you assess it? Did you get everything accomplished that you wanted to, or how do you assess that?
We're moving. You know, I still feel like, you know, today's the next step in that. You know, we got another practice tomorrow. We have our mock game on Saturday. Those things all go into your preparation. And so really, in my mind, you know, you want to have everything. When we walk off that field Saturday afternoon, I want to feel great about what we've done and where we're at. And then we move our entire focus to Ball State.
How much different has camp been with the coordinator changes that you made?
Yeah, it's been different. You know, actually a little more enjoyable for me in regards to player opportunities. I've had a chance to meet with more guys one-on-one. I love doing that. That's really kind of where I connect with our guys. It's hard to do that when you're calling the defense, and it's hard to do that. I feel like I've got a much better feel for all three phases of the game, feel more comfortable with where we're at in those areas because I've been able to be in those meetings, have those conversations, have that big picture view of the program. And so it just makes me feel better. You know, I feel like in the last couple of years, you're always kind of like, there's never enough time in the day to get everything done you want to get done. And so you're always fighting that a little bit. But at the same time, I feel a lot more comfortable with where we're at, feel better about where we're at, and just feel like we're more well-prepared in the football team.
How often would you like to play here?
Excuse me?
How often would you like to play here?
Well, we're going to be playing here. You know, once a year is great to start the season or have any kind of an opponent that we choose to play here. I think it's a great thing. And then obviously when Andrew season here.
Did you grow up a Colts fan?
I did. You know, just because when they came here, especially when Coach Dungy came, I just, this the whole, everything changed. But you're obviously a fan because it's the team that, that represents your state, and you get a chance to come and watch, you know, as a kid you come. And I was, I believe I was, I think I was in middle school when they came here, you know, and so just getting into high school and stuff. But then really when I really became, when Peyton came and everything started changing, and Coach Dungy came, and just the respect I had for the players that he brought here, and I got a chance to know some of those guys when I was at Ben Davis, and they would come and do our chapels and speak to our team, and just one of them did an internship with our players, and Cato June, and got a chance to know him well through that process, and Jeff Saturday and Tark Glenn and Hunter Smith, and those guys really, they came over quite a bit, and so really a ton of respect for what they represented on and off the field, and obviously the product was pretty special. Playing at a high level, and so it was just a neat time, and from that point on, it's just been really, really, you know, wanted to see him do really well.
Thanks,
great. Thanks.